Hello and good day, welcome to our YouTube channel God's Promises and Todays. Video will be Book of Psalms, Chapter 78. Let's get started now. Psalm 78 is a long psalm attributed to Asaph, one of the leaders of King David's Shoir. It is a didactic poem that tells the history of Israel from their deliverance from Egypt to the establishment of David's kingdom. Asaph exhorts the people of Israel to learn from their past mistakes, trust in God's faithfulness, and obey His commandments. The psalm can be divided into three parts, a call to listen and learn from Israel's history, a recounting of Israel's disobedience and God's judgment, and a plea for God's mercy and restoration. The first section of the psalm, verses 1-8, sets the tone and purpose for the rest of the poem. Asaph urges the people to listen carefully to what he has to say, to learn from the mistakes of their ancestors, and to pass on God's laws and stories to the next generation. He emphasizes the importance of teaching children and grandchildren about God's deeds, so that they too might put their trust in Him. In the second section, verses 9-72, Asaph retells the story of Israel's rebellion and God's judgment. He begins with the plagues in Egypt, the parting of the Red Sea, and the provision of manna in the wilderness. Despite God's miraculous deliverance, the people of Israel continually rebelled against Him. They forgot His commandments, worshipped idols, and provoked His anger with their unbelief. As a result, God sent a series of judgments upon them, including snakes, death, and the fate in battle. However, even in His anger, God did not forsake His people. He continued to provide for them and showed mercy when they repented and turned back to Him. In the final section, verses 73-72, Asaph concludes the psalm with a plea for God's mercy and restoration. He reminds God of His past faithfulness to Israel and as Him to once again intervene on their behalf. He prays that God will rise up a shepherd for His people, a leader who will guide them in righteousness and bring them peace. Asaph ends the psalm with a note of hope and confidence in God's power and love for His people. The teaching application of Psalm 78 is clear: learn from the mistakes of the past, trust in God's faithfulness, and obey His commandments. Asaph exhorts us to pass on our faith to the next generation, to tell them the stories of God's deeds and to teach them His laws. He warns us of the dangers of unbelief and disobedience, and reminds us of the consequences of rebellion against God. However, he also points us to the mercy and grace of God, who is always ready to forgive and restore those who turn back to Him. In today's world, it is easy to forget the lessons of the past and to fall into the same patterns of unbelief and disobedience as the people of Israel did. Psalm 78 calls us to remember God's faithfulness and to trust in Him, even in the midst of trials and difficulties. It reminds us of the importance of passing on our faith to the next generation and of the need to teach them the stories and commandments of God. Finally, it offers us hope and confidence in God's power and love, knowing that He will never forsake us or abandon us. Obrigado por nós. Por favor, compartilhe conosco o seu capítulo bíblico favorito, abaixo na seção de comentários. Não se esqueça de curtir e se inscrever, isso realmente ajuda nosso canal a crescer. Espero vê-lo de volta aqui para o nosso próximo vídeo. Cuide-se sempre bem!